Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed that the electric field intensity due to a uniformly charge distributed straight conductor along the direction of conductor as well as from the normal to the conductor. We discussed the electric field intensities. Then we'll go for the next case, that electric field intensity due to a charged ring. Next one is electric field intensity due to a charged ring. Charged ring. So let us take a charged ring of radius is R. So along its axis. Suppose if you given a charge Q for it. Along its axis at a distance x, what is the electric field intensity? You can discuss it. Now we will take a charged ring. So the charged ring radius is like this. We are given a charged ring is there. So for this ring, we given a charge Q for it. So this is a charged ring. So for this, it is having charge Q, whose radius is R. This radius is R. Now you consider a charged ring of radius R and having charge Q on it. So completely this body, this ring is having charge Q on it. Now along its axis at a distance x, so from the center of this axis at a distance x here, we need to be find have the what is the electric field intensity E is how much we need it. So this is the procedure and all, we no need to be solve directly. We can take the expression for it. The electric field intensity at this point E is, here radius is R and Q x is the distance. The electric field intensity at point P, the electric field intensity at point P, intensity at point P is E equal to here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Qx by R square plus X square whole raised to 3 by 2, and its electric field intensity is along, away from the what center. So its direction is away from the center. So like this, we have the electric field intensity expression. So along the axis of a circular charged conductor here, where x is the distance from the center to the point where you want to find the electric field intensity, R is the radius, Q is the total charge. So here you can also write this expression in terms of charge density. So here it is a linear type of conductor. So in terms of charge density, if they ask here, in terms of charge density, we can write charge density lambda equal to charge per unit length, charge per Q, given charge is Q, length in the sense the perimeter of the ring. So perimeter of the ring is 2 pi R. Then charge means you can write lambda into 2 pi R. So if you write that in this expression, you have the intensity expression in terms of lambda, E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Q place you can write lambda into 2 pi R into X by R square plus X square whole raised to 3 by 2. Then 2 pi 2 times cancelled. Then can write lambda R x by 2 into R square epsilon naught is there. So 2 epsilon naught into r square plus x square whole raised to 3 by 2. This is the expression. So this is in terms of lambda. Otherwise, we have direct expression like this. Based on this, you have to understand one thing is that, so at the center of the ring, at x distance, you have this expression. At the center of the ring, what is the electric field intensity in the sensor? Here, case you can write, at center of the ring, at center of the ring, we have the expression that center of the ring means exactly here we need to be take. Here in the sense, x value 0. So x is equals to 0 if you substitute in this expression, x in the 0 in the sense this complete expression becomes 0. The electric field intensity at the center of the ring E equal to 0. So at the center of the ring, electric field intensity is 0. The same way, you can understand that when this electric field intensity maximum means here it is 0, on either side where it is maximum, that you have to be find it out, and as well as the electric field intensity maximum in the sense the electric field intensity maximum. So when the electric field intensity maxima, so any expression, so you want to be get its maximum value in the sense, so we should be differentiate it, means you have to differentiate with respect to n, then you can able to, for which value of x, this electric field intensity will be maximum you can get. So to get the maximum field, electric field intensity, we have to make it dE by dx, you have to be make it 0. Then this differentiation, if you do it, and finally you will get here r, x is equals to, so r by plus r minus r by root 2. Then if you substitute u by v rule, if you apply, and finally you can get one expression that finally x is equals to plus r minus r by root 2. Meaning is, left side at minus r by 2 distance intensity maxima, right side at r by 2 distance intensity is maximum. So what is that maximum value? So we can say that the maximum value in the sense here, I can show you the variation. Suppose if you take the variation of electric field intensity versus the electric field intensity versus distance, if you taken, so exactly at a distance r equal to x is equals to plus r by root 2, exactly at minus x is equals to minus r by root 2, at these places we have maximum intensity. So you can understand the maximum intensity here, the maximum intensity here it is there. Negative side maximum, this side it will be there, and positive side maximum, this side it will be there. So here negative side maximum, and here positive side maximum will be there. Exactly at center it will be 0. Then you can understand what is the maximum value in the sense x place you have to substitute r by root 2. What is the electric field intensity expression we have? Electric field intensity E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into x by r square plus x square whole raised to 3 by 2. So E max, maximum value, when you will get, when you substitute in place of x, r by root 2. So E max we can get, when x is equals to r by root 2. Then if you substitute that, you will get E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into r by root 2 by r square plus x square. X square means r square by 2, because r by root 2 x means whole raised to 3 by 2. Then you will get 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This is the maximum electric field intensity q r by root 2. Here r square, if it is comes outside, so here you will get 2r square plus r square means 3r square by 2 whole raised to 3 by 2. Then you will get 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught a r by root 2, and 3 power 3 by 2 in the sense 3 root 3 r square whole raised to 3 by 2 in the sense r cube by 2 power 3 by 2 in the sense 2 root 2. Then root 2 root 2 gets cancelled. R one time it is cancelled r square. Then 2 if it is goes to numerator it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here q is also be there. Q. So q into 2 is goes to numerator 2 by 3 root 3 r square. Therefore we can write 2 by 3 root 3 into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. This is what E max, and this is possible at a distance r plus r by 2 and at a distance minus r by 2 from the center of the ring. So these are the things we are discussing directly, because in the objectives directly they will ask these results only. Okay, don't worry about the remaining things, how it is came and all. It is a lengthy process. Instead of that and all not required for us. So directly we are taking the result of it. So what is the maximum value, and when it is a maximum value, when it is maximum value, the distance x is equals to r by root 2. So in this way you can able to find the electric field intensity due to a charged ring along its axis. Next we can go for the another case that suppose instead of complete circular ring, if arc shaped ring is there, so due to a charged arc, so what is the electric field intensity at its center? So due to a charged arc, so due to a charged arc, the electric field intensity, at its center, arc here. So electric field intensity due to the charged arc at its center here. So I am taking a charged arc which subtends an angle theta. So charged arc which subtends an angle theta, due to the charged arc what is the electric field intensity, we will be discuss it here now. So we are not taking complete circle, we are taking only a charged arc like this. So like this we have a charged arc. So this charged arc is subtends here, it is a subtends an angle. See this spot you are taking, this is the center O. So if you are taking at this point P, you observe this is not exactly from the center of the arc. So angle is different here. This angle is theta 1. This angle is theta 2. Then as similar to the previous case, here also the electric field intensity is along x-axis, along y-axis will be there. So this is the electric field intensity along x-axis of this arc, that is Ex. And upper major, below theta 1, theta 2 both are same. Electric field intensity due to the upper part, electric field into the lower part are equal and opposite. That will be cancelled. But only one larger spot, another one smaller part is there. So because of this larger part, resultant electric field intensity along downwards is there. So the resultant electric field intensity is Ey, which is downwards. So like this we have two electric field intensities, Ex and Ey. So Ex expression we can write as Ex is equals to electric field intensity Ex, as similar to the previous case, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, this radius is r. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught r into sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2, the same expression we have. Similarly Ey we have the expression lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This is the expression. So based on this, we can understand that if it is a semicircle, what will be happen is we can find it out. We say a semicircular part is there exactly at the center, what is the electric field intensity? And if it is exactly theta 1 and theta 2, if it is equal, we can also find what is the electric field intensity. Such cases we can determine it. Let us take that if it is a semicircular arc, if it is a semicircular arc, if it is a semicircular arc in the sense you understand clearly that this is the arc shape. So this is the arc shape we have. Then this is completely positively charged. Then with respect to center O, what is happened? Theta 1 becomes 90, theta 2 becomes 90 degrees. So theta 1 is 90 degrees, theta 2 is 90 degrees. Then what about the electric field intensities of this one? Electric field intensity Ex, Ex is nothing but Ex equal to lambda by, where lambda is charge density. Charge density, the linear charge density in that sense, charge per unit length of this conductor, lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r into sine 90 plus sine 90, so that is 1 plus 1, that is lambda by 2, because 2 here, 4, 2 times cancel, 2 pi epsilon naught r. Similarly, Ey, if you take an Ey, is nothing but lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r, cos 90 minus cos 90 is 0 minus 0, that is completely it is 0. Only what we have electric field intensity along this direction, x direction, that is Ex is equals to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught r. So like this you can able to find the semicircular arc, what is the electric field intensity. Like the complete circle, if it is there, you may understand. So it will be around completely, what will happen is this half electric field intensity Ex, this side is there. Another part, if you take on this side, equal electric field intensity, left side will be there. Then resultant electric field intensity becomes 0. As we discussed in the, so left side part, electric field intensity in the right hand side direction. Right side part, electric field intensity equal in magnitude in the left side. Then those two electric field intensity cancels. Then what happens? Net electric field intensity due to complete part will be 0. So that is what we discussed in the ring case. Exactly at center, the electric field intensity is 0 we discussed. So in the same way, we have another case that circular disc is there. What is the electric field intensity due to the circular disc from its center at a distance x? What is the electric field intensity? So that is we can discuss it. So electric field intensity due to the circular disc along its from the center, we can discuss that expression. So next one, electric field intensity due to circular disc. Okay. So circular disc in the sense, here we have a circular disc like this. So this is a circular disc. So due to this circular disc, completely this is charged. So complete surface is became charged in the sense, the previous case is the charged linearly, but this is the charged what, surface wise. So it is having surface charge density sigma. So the disc is uniformly charged. Disc is uniformly charged, having charge density having charge density sigma. Having charge density sigma. So whose radius? Let it be whose radius if we take it as R. If this radius is R, from this center O at a distance x, from this center O at a distance x, what is the electric field intensity due to this discharge disk? So here electric field intensity we want it. So the electric field intensity due to this case is electric field intensity E equal to, we have sigma by 2 epsilon naught at P into 1 minus here x by root over x square plus r square. This is the standard result. So electric field intensity at a point P, which is at a distance x in the sense, sigma by 2 epsilon naught into 1 minus x by root over x square plus r square. This is what the result of the electric field intensity due to a circular disk at its center. Sorry, at a distance x from its center. If you want it at center in the sense, x you have to make it 0. X if you make it 0, what you will get? Sigma by epsilon naught. So at the center of the disk, if you want the electric field, at center of disk, the electric field intensity we can write as a electric field intensity center in the sense x value 0. X if you put 0 in this expression, electric field intensity at center equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught into what? 1 minus 0. That is, you will get sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is the electric field intensity at its center. So these are the different cases what we have discussed in the what in objectives: charged rod, charged ring, charged disc. So in these cases, the electric field intensity is what we are discussing. So next we have to go for the solid angle. What is a solid angle? And based on the solid angle, so what is the how the electric field intensity? Already we know electric field intensity is inversely proportional to distance square. Using solid angle, we have to prove the electric field intensity is inversely proportional to the distance square. So then we will go for that. Next one is a solid angle. So up to now this is object 2. Now we can go for the actual concept. So before the Gauss law, we have to discuss these points and all. Then we will go for the next concept called Gauss law here. So before Gauss law, I am going to discuss one more that is point, that is solid angle. So from this I want to be arrive the result that electric field strength decreases inversely with distance. If distance increases, electric field intensity increases. If distance increases, electric field intensity decreases. So that is, we have to be arrive the result using this solid angle concept. See, what is a solid angle in the sense? So usually, you know, two dimensional angle, if a sector is there, so if the two planes are there, if it is makes an angle theta, if this is an arc length, if the radius is r, arc length is x. So that is O, AB. Here plane angle theta we can write as a plane angle. So plane angle in the sense, this arc, how much angle it subtends at its center, that is plane angle we can write. The plane angle theta is equals to arc length x by radius is r. Theta angle is equals to arc length by radius we have. Then x, arc length x is equals to, we can write theta into radius. The same way, this is two dimensional, but in three dimensional if you take it, instead of two planes we have a cone. Means if you observe it, if a solid sphere if you taken, in a solid sphere if you cut a tap and small part of it, that is electing how it will get, it will gets like a cone. So it is in two dimension. It is in two dimension. But in three dimension, you will get it like this. In three dimension, if you take a cone, ice cream type cone, if you take a cone, here, this is the lateral surface of the cone. So this is, we can call it as a lateral surface of the cone. lateral surface of cone. This lateral surface, how much angle it makes at its vertex? This is the vertex. The lateral surface, how much angle this lateral surface is? S. And this radius of this cone is R. The three-dimensional angle made by the lateral surface at its vertex. This angle is called as the solid angle and is represented with omega. So this is what we can call it as a solid angle. So how you wrote here the linear angle theta is equal to arc length by radius. Here you can write solid angle in the sense you can write as a solid angle. You can write omega is equals to lateral surface area S by radius square. Lateral surface area S by radius square. And from this lateral surface area S in the sense, lateral surface area S is equals to, we can write sigma R square. So it means solid angle into R square. So like this you can able to find the lateral surface area by multiplying solid angle with this one. And units for here theta is units is radians we use. Here the solid angle units is, units for a solid angle we'll write as a solid angle is steradians. Units for solid angle is steradians, we'll use it. And from this our intention is to prove electric field strength is inversely proportional to the distance square. Strength decreases when you go away from the charge, that we need to be prove it. Let us take the charge is located at the vertex of a cone. Let a Q charge is there which is located at the vertex of the cone. Then the electric field lines from this charge will be emanates radially in all the directions here. The electric field lines from this charge is emanates radially in all the directions. Now this is a electric field lines passing here vertex O. Here I am considering two surface areas. One is at a distance R1. Here one surface area I am considering. Here one surface area which is at point P1. And one more surface area I am considering at a distance R2. So at a distance R2, one more surface area I am considering which is at P2. This is another surface area S2. This is another surface area S2. Now, you observe here, through this surface area, number of electric field lines passing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Through this area, 5 passing, through this area also, 5 only passing. And these two surface areas subtended an angle, solid angle, same only. Solid angle subtended by these two surface area S1 as well as S2 is also be same. Then you may understand that here electric field strength we can say as number of electric field lines passing per unit area is nothing but the strength of the electric field. Here strength of electric field you take as a E1. Here electric field strength as E1. Here electric field strength as E2 if you taken. Here number of electric field lines are same. Number of electric field lines through S1 and S2 is same, that is N. And a solid angle delta also be same, is same. Then electric field intensity is directly proportional to number of electric field lines per unit area. So area S1 is nothing but you can write sigma R1 square. Here S1 means sigma R1 square. Here S1 in the sense of sigma R1 square. S2 in the sense sigma R2 square. You see the formula here. surface area is nothing but solid angle into distance square here. So S1 is a distance R1, S2 is a distance R2. So S1, S2 we calculated. Strength of electric field is nothing but is directly proportional to number of electric field lines per area. Then E1 by E2. So E1 by E2 in the sense we can write as a E1 by E2 in the sense E1 in the sense number of electric field lines passing through surface S1. E2 in the sense number of electric field lines passing through surface S2. What you observe from these two surfaces, number of electric field lines passing is same. That's why N by S1. S1 in the sense what you can write sigma R1 square by the number of electric field lines through S2. That is the number of electric field lines by S2. What is S2? Sigma R2 square. So you can understand N is remain same, number of electric field lines remain same through S1 as well as S2. So N same cancelled. And these two surface areas subtending in same solid angle omega will be cancelled. Then it is equal to what? R2 square by R1 square. So E1 by E2 is equal to R2 by R1 square, means you can also write as E is inversely proportional to distance square. So strength of the electric field is decreases with distance. So that is you can able to understand from this solid angle concept. So in the next class we can discuss the important concept, that is Gauss law. So that is we will be discussing. It is very important. I will be discuss that one as well as applications on basis on Gauss law also.